Now it's Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
I think there's a lot of confusion out there. You have people in the same household, some testing positive, some testing negative. They don't know whether to wait 5 days or 10 days. Do I have to take a test? Are the tests accurate at home? Could you just give us an overview real quick?
Yeah, that's a tough one. Number one, if the tests really were available, everybody would be taking the tests. We would be telling you, take a test, take a test, take a test. Now, does the test work as good as it did before for Omicron? It works a little bit less, but it's still helpful, especially if you do multiple tests, which is exactly what people in the government don't want to tell you because, you know, they don't have enough tests to even test once. So, you know, that is a problem that's going to be solved. You know, making these tests just takes manufacturing, but, you know, you just don't flick a switch. But the tests really are helpful. And you have to repeat them. Now, to make the diagnosis, the best tests are the molecular tests, like the PCR tests. But there's some other rapid tests as well. They're expensive, though.
There's also some contradiction about the hospitalization rates. We keep hearing Omicron is less severe, but we keep hearing hospitalizations are up. Are these people mostly that are not vaccinated, or is everyone going to the hospital? What's happening here?
Well, yes, it's less severe. So you have, let's just say, for all practical purposes, it's half the hospitalization rate as Delta. However, you got three times as many infections. So that means there's more people in the hospital. What we're paying for now is the holidays and the fact that we did not mitigate during the holidays. Every, you know, we had New Year's Eve celebrations, people, there's unrestricted flying with no checking of vaccines or tests on domestic flights or whatever. It's like, you know, people just acted just like nothing was going on, that you were in the middle of this pandemic. So we're going to get that holiday, we're going to pay for that holiday in January. And the numbers are, this is going to be a really bad month.
And schools closed three days in a row now. In your professional opinion, do you think Chicago public schools are safe enough to open and have in-person learning?
It is not safe to open the schools. I'm sorry. It's very bad to do home learning. I mean, that doesn't work as good. Everybody knows that. But look is what's happening. They can't even keep the schools open. They don't even have enough employees to work and to keep the schools open. You were just interviewing that teacher. It just isn't safe now. Why can't they just say, okay, January is a write-off? Why don't you just, like, stop going to school, you know, work remotely for a month until this thing starts to calm down, until we get over this holiday bump? Schools are not safe right now.
All right, let's get to some viewer questions. A new report finds that T cells have been found to handle Omicron. Thoughts on if this is a step in the right direction to make our way out of the pandemic?
Well, we've known this from the beginning. So you have, like, two parts of the immune system. You have the antibodies that are like the infantry frontline soldiers that just appear there really quickly after you're infected. With Omicron, they don't work, all right? The Omicron has figured out a way around them. However, you've got these memory cells in your body, which we call the T cells, and they get activated after you get infected, but it takes them about 5 days to work. So what happens is with Omicron, you get infected. Unfortunately, you have a breakthrough, which is pretty common, but it dampens down the whole infection, these T cells. This has been going on. This is from the beginning. The problem is it's very difficult to measure T cells. It's really an intense laboratory test. So you're never going to be able to go, hey, check my T cells. That's not going to work. But that's why the vaccinated are not in the hospital now. The hospital is 90%. Unvaccinated. The ICU is over 95% unvaccinated. The kids that are getting infected, which is this is just outrageous how many kids are ending up in the hospital now, they're unvaccinated, not only because they're not eligible for the vaccine, the ones under five anyway, but they come from families that are also unvaccinated. So the whole thing is being driven by the people that are getting infected more often and don't have the protection to avoid severe disease.
All right, one more question. Are nose swabs as effective as detecting Omicron, or are throat swabs better?
Yeah, this story is really floating around. Somebody did a throat swab, said it worked better. Okay, that's very nice. However, all the studies have been done. There's two things to remember. When you get COVID, it's all over your head. It's in your nose, it's in your throat, it's in your saliva, it's everywhere. And it's in very high amounts in all those places. Yes, at one particular time, one site may be positive and the other site may be negative, depending on the test that you're doing, but it's really kind of everywhere. And the tests were not designed to look at oral swabs. So, you know, you have different bacteria in the mouth and viruses in the mouth and stuff. So, you know, whether or not that's going to interfere with the test or give you a false positive or a false negative, we don't really know. So, you know, I would not base a decision on switching to the oral swab based on what I've seen so far.
All right.
I know it works. Yeah. And there's plenty of the virus in the nose. So just stick with the nasal swab. It's actually easier.
All right. If you didn't get your question answered, Dr. Murphy answers them biweekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via email. Go to our Morning News Facebook page and post one there. We'll talk to him again on Monday. Have a good weekend.
Thanks, doctor.
Great. Have a great weekend.